Hi, today I'm going to focus on how you can create your own blueprints to easily create automations and scripts in Home Assistant. Let's dive into this. One of the powerful possibilities of Home Assistant is that you can create blueprints. Blueprints are YAML files that function as a template that can be used to generate an automation or a script. This can come in very handy as soon as you want to create multiple automations that have the same functionalities but use different devices or entities. Next to that, you can share blueprints with others so that they can easily create automations and scripts using your blueprints. I am only going to explain in this Home Assistant tutorial how you can create your own blueprints and how you can use them after you've created them. So, how does this work? When you install Home Assistant, there are two blueprints installed already. You will see them as soon as you go to Settings, Automations and Scenes, and when you click Create Automation. Here you can select to create a new automation or create an automation based on a blueprint. You will see the two sample blueprints in this list. But there is another way to do this, and that is by going to the Blueprints tab. Here you see all the blueprints that are available in your system. You see that blueprints for automations and scripts are available. When you click on the three dots next to a blueprint, you can create an automation or a script based on this blueprint. If your blueprint contains a source URL, you can share this blueprint with other people using the Share Blueprint option. I will focus on creating a blueprint for an automation in this tutorial, but it works exactly the same for a script. So, I created some blueprints myself for the Ulanzi desktop clock. If you click on Create Automation for the Alteryx Create Notification Blueprint, you see a lot of options that you can choose from. There are a lot of different selectors that you can choose, like a drop-down, a color selector and a toggle. The complete list of selectors can be found on this page. For this tutorial, I am going to create a blueprint for the following use case. Turn lights on and off on motion when the lux value is below a certain threshold. You can start writing a blueprint from scratch, but it's way easier to first create an automation and generate your blueprint based on this automation. I created this automation for this tutorial. I start with two triggers. The first one is a state trigger that checks if motion is detected from clear to detected. If you look at the YAML of this trigger, you see that it checks from off to on, which is the same as checking from clear to detected. I named the trigger ID for this trigger on. If you don't know what trigger IDs are, then please watch this video where I explain how trigger IDs work. The second trigger checks if motion is stopped for 10 seconds and I named the trigger ID off. I defined an if-then action in the action section. Within the if action, I check if the trigger with trigger ID on is triggered, and I check if the lux value of my motion sensor is below a certain value, so that this action will only be called when it's dark enough for me. Within then, I turn on a certain light in a specific color using the light turn on service. You do not have to apply a color to the light if you don't want to, but I want to show you in this tutorial how you can work with an RGB selector in the blueprint. Within else, I just turn off the light. You might ask yourself why I choose to use the services light turn on and light turn off, and why I don't just choose to turn on a device. Well, if you use the light turn on and light turn off services, you have two advantages. The first advantage is that you can point to an entity ID instead of a device ID. If you ever have to replace your light bulb, that new light bulb will have a new device ID, and in that case you have to go through all your automations to select the new light bulb device. If you use the entity ID, you just have to assign that entity ID to the new light bulb and all your automations will just keep working. The second advantage is that you get a lot more options that you can set for your light bulb, like brightness, color, color temperature, etc. So, using the call service action is most of the time a better choice than using the device action. Now that the automation is created, we can copy the YAML of this automation to use it as the source for our blueprint. For this, go to the three dots in the upper right corner and click on Edit in YAML. Select the YAML code using Ctrl or Command A and copy the code to your clipboard using Ctrl or Command C. We will use this code in the blueprint that we are going to create in a minute. To edit blueprints, you need a text editor like Studio Code Server or File Editor. You can install Studio Code Server by going to Settings, Add-ons. Click on Add-on Store. Search for Studio Code Server and install Studio Code Server. Make sure that Show in Sidebar is selected and start the add-on. Now let's click on the Studio Code Server link to open the editor. You see all the files on your Home Assistant server here. We are going to create a new blueprint in the Blueprints folder. There are two folders within the Blueprints folder. The Automation folder contains all the blueprints for automations. The Script folder contains all the blueprints for the scripts. Let's open the Automation folder. I like to create a folder for my own blueprint, so I created the folder Smart Home Junkie. Let's select this folder and create a new file in this folder by clicking on the new file icon. I'll give this file the name toggle-light-on-motion-and-locks.yaml. Now paste the automation code that we copied to our clipboard using Ctrl or Command V. I need your help. You will be doing me a huge favor if you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And you help me a lot if you also give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment. This way, YouTube will present this video to new people and that will make the channel grow. Thank you. We have to convert this automation code to a blueprint. Therefore, we start with the line blueprint. Then we will give our blueprint a name and description. The name will be shown in the list of blueprints when we create an automation. This blueprint is an automation blueprint, so we will give it the domain automation. I am the author of this blueprint, so I will add myself as the author of the blueprint. These were the general settings of the blueprint. You can also add a source URL where the blueprint can be found on GitHub if you like, but it's not mandatory. Now the fun starts because we are going to define the fields that the user can choose in our blueprint. We want the user to choose the following devices and settings: the light entity, the light color, the motion sensor, the lux sensor, the maximum lux value within which the light may switch on, and the wait time before the light turns off after no motion is detected. For each of these inputs, we are going to add an entry to the blueprint. We start with the line input. Then we are defining the light entity. We name the light entity input light target. The light entity has a name and we want to let the user select the light entity, so we define a selector of type entity. To make sure that the user can only select light entities, we add a domain filter of type light. You can add multiple domains here if you like. Next, we want to select a light color, so we add a new input with the identifier RGB color. Its name is lightbulb color, and we want the user to select a color, so we are defining a color RGB selector here. The default value will be white, which is 255, 255, 255. The motion sensor input looks a lot like the light entry that we defined earlier. The difference is that we filter on the domain binary sensor and the device class motion. The lux sensor input looks a lot like the motion sensor input. Here we filter on the domain sensor and the device class illuminance. The lux value is a value input. You don't really need to use a selector for such a value. I set the default to 50. And the wait time input uses the number selector with the mode slider, which will make sure that the slider is shown between the minimum and maximum value. The unit of measurement is seconds and I set the default to 120 seconds. The mode of the automation is single. This can also be restart, queued or parallel, but single is fine for me. There are multiple roads to Rome on how to create this type of automation. Now we are going to rebuild the triggers of our automation so that the blueprint knows what to do with it. All we have to do is replace the entities and values that we use in our triggers with the input fields that we defined above. So for the first trigger, we replace the binary sensor with input motion entity. For the second trigger, we replace the binary sensor with input motion entity as well. And we replace the seconds value with our input wait time. We do not have conditions, so we can leave that code as is and hop over to the actions. In the actions code, we will replace all our entities and values with the input fields that we defined above too. Within the if condition, we replace the entity ID for the lux sensor with input lux entity, and we replace the value 400 with input lux value. Within the then part, we replace the color code with input RGB color and the target entity ID with input light target. And finally, in the else part, we replace the entity ID with input light target as well. This way, our blueprint is not pointing to hard-coded entities and values anymore, but will make use of the entities and values that the user selects when he or she creates an automation using this blueprint. Now, let's save this blueprint and activate it in Home Assistant. The next step isn't really needed if there are no automations created with the blueprint yet, but it's good practice to do this every time after you change your blueprint to make sure that all automations that were created with this blueprint are synced to the new blueprint. For this, go to the developer tools and click on the automations link in the YAML tab. Now, let's see if the blueprint works. Go to settings, automations and scenes, and click on the blueprints tab. If everything went well, you will see your new blueprint in this list. If your blueprint contains an error, the error will be shown here as well. I must say that not all errors are shown here all of the time, so sometimes you might have to debug your blueprint if it does not work. Click on the three dots next to the blueprint and select Create Automation. Now fill in all the fields and save the automation. Your automation should now work and your light will turn on and off based on motion when the lux value is below the value that you've entered. This is a simple example of how a blueprint works, but you can do much more using variables and selectors. You can type the code of this blueprint for free from the screen or buy me a coffee and get this code in return. See the links to the code, the blueprint possibilities and selectors in the description below this video. If my work saves your time, please consider becoming one of my patrons, just like these awesome people did. You play a vital role in making it possible for me to create these Home Assistant tutorials. And please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to help the channel grow. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye. Okay. Here you go.